Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to share with you guys a few hairstyles that are very simple, beginner friendly, easy, and are really great if you want your hair out of your face when you're exercising. And this is going to be for my viewers or anyone who is watching this video that has longer hair, because I don't know how to style shorter hair. I'm sorry, but this is just what I do when I'm, let's say, running and I want hair out of my face. So if this is something that you're interested in, then keep on watching and let's jump into the tutorial right now. Pew. The first hairstyle we're going to do is a simple two braids. So now that your hair is split into two equal sections, we're going to divide this first section into approximately three equal parts. So now we have one, two, and three. So this is how I'm going to hold it. I'm literally going to hold it in between my thumb and my index finger, sometimes even pinching it like so, or just like inside like so. And then my middle finger, this guy, don't want to flip you guys off, this guy right here, is going to literally grab the middle guy like a little hook, and you're gonna twist, so the outer section guy becomes the middle, right? And then pinching again the middle guy with my index and thumb, and then taking this guy and bringing him into the middle, like so. So again, pinching, hook, bring that guy into the middle, and then you can also, instead of like taking this guy, putting him in the middle, you can also take the middle guy and just bring him over like so. So basically you're trying to get all the outer strands into the middle. And make sure when you're doing your braid, you don't want to do it too loosely either. Yeah, and then you just do that all the way to the end of your hair. So I know this style might be the simplest of styles. It's just a classic braid, but you know, this is different if you don't want to always do ponytails all the time, especially because if you have like really thick hair or a lot of hair, it's kind of hard to tie your hair, right? Like your hair, your ponytail will just migrate down and become very, very, like a very low ponytail. Sometimes it'll slip out of your hair tie. So this is why I like doing braids, because I don't have to worry about my ponytail starting from here and then migrating like all the way down to here throughout my run, and then having like, you know, like the loose hair kind of like hitting me in the face, ow, like ow, ow, and then always like sticking towards my neck. So this is why I prefer to do a simple braid rather than a ponytail. And let's say you don't have that kind of issue, I still think that a braid would be nice, because though I think hair ties can be, like ponytails can be quite painful and damaging to your hair if you do it very often. So this is why I like to do braids. It's just a lot more gentler. So I'm working on the other section now, and the same thing. I like to kind of pinch, take my middle finger, kind of hook it in, and literally just like swap places. Almost there. Okay, I'm calling it good. I'm going to tie this end off. So yay, we have our two braids. You can make it look a lot more cuter if you kind of just like pull the little braids so it looks like you have fuller volume. And if you are an expert, more of an expert than me, and know how to do like really cute, like, is it Dutch braids? Like braids that kind of go down here. I think that will look really cute and would work really well because you have this hair kind of like out, like tucked away from your face, which is really great. And this is also really nice too. If you're going hiking, you're going running, you're just outside, outdoors, and you need to wear a hat, you don't have to worry about your ponytail kind of, I guess, not working out with your cap, because you can literally just take your cap and go like this. Ta-da! And you don't have to worry. Hold on. Let me tighten it. Yeah. So just put on your cap like so, and you don't have to worry about your ponytail blocking your hat or anything like this. I hope that looks good from the back. I don't know. But yeah, and I think this is super cute, and it's very casual. But let's say you're like, okay, this is cute, but I don't like this. Like, maybe you're doing sports and you're like, my hair is too long, like me, and sometimes it literally just like whack your, like I literally whack myself with my hair, like ow, ow. So what do I do? Help me. So what I like to do is literally take my braids and twist it away from my face like this and make two little low buns. Not only is it cute, but it completely gets my hair out of my face. And I don't have to worry about hair literally whacking me when I'm, I don't know, when I'm like doing any kind of physical exercise. So this is just a bun, and you can secure it with really cute, like another hair tie, or like really cute scrunchies like this. See, now everything is like away from my face. And I don't have to worry about wind. I don't have to worry about potentially getting hurt because my hair keeps on like hitting me in the face. But it's okay. You just do two little cute low buns like so. And then when you run, you don't have to worry about like hair whipping around. And yeah, subscribe. Okay, so now you may be wondering, okay, but going back, what if I do want to wear the hat? How does this work? Well, you can just wear the hat like so if your bun is low enough. Mine is not quite as low, but this is what I also like to do. I guess it's kind of like a hair hack, maybe. Ooh, I think I have to be careful about calling it hack. Ooh, okay. So what I like to do is actually first take my hat, and you know how caps always have like this little hole on the back? So I don't think this is a hair hack, because I think maybe a lot of people do this, but I like to kind of take it back like this, like I'm about to do a ponytail, right? But I like to put it through the cap hole, like so. Ta-da. And this is so if there's wind and you have like a hairstyle here and then the wind blows, it would just like go like this. Like your hat won't fly away, it'll just kind of like this, and you can kind of just put it back like so. I don't know. It's probably not a hack. Like I said, everybody does this. But I like to kind of put it through, and now we can either make one low bun or two low bun. I'm gonna show you the single bun because I already done the two low buns. So for the single bun, it's pretty simple. Just take your hair. First of all, make sure that your cap isn't tightened or adjusted to your head if you need to adjust it, if you're the type of person who needs to adjust it, if that makes sense. I have a very small head, so I always need to adjust it, and this is basically how I figure out how to wear a big cap and have it not like fly away when I'm running. But so basically this is very loose, as you can see. I haven't like tightened or anything. Taking this and literally just twisting it. So now it's twisted. I know my hat looks really weird because it's not tightened, but taking my hair tie, and now I'm gonna tie this hair and secure it into a low bun. And also, I know I'm like here and here, it's because I don't have a mic and I want you guys to hear me. Yeah.
Okay, so, ta-da,
it's tied. Wow, it's a low bun. Okay, great. Now, yeah, see, it's not really tightened, but now, what I can do is literally just take this, pull it tight, adjust it to the,
it so it's tight,
and ta-da! I know this is really simple, but this is really helpful. Oh, I also want to mention that I know I said this video is geared for fitness, but actually if you work in like anywhere where you need to wear a cap, let's say you're a barista, you make smoothies, juices, whatever, you work in a food place and they want you to wear a cap, this is a good hairstyle. And the two low buns are super cute. I highly recommend the two low buns if you want to look extra cute, but this is a good kind of hairstyle. I know it might seem very basic, but I don't know, I feel like a lot of people just wear a ponytail and they go running, but this is what I wear when I go running because I don't really have to worry about anything flying in my view when I'm running. I can just focus on my running. Yeah, this is basically my hair, my three hair styles for when it's hot outside and you want your hair on your face, when you're exercising, when it's windy outside. I don't really know what to title this video or these hairstyle looks, but these are just three really great hairstyles if you want hair on your face. Hopefully I explained everything enough. It's basically just like a classic braid. A braid into a bun, either a single bun or double buns, or no braid and then a single bun or a double bun. And that's basically it. It's very simple, very beginner friendly. Yeah, and also, oh, I almost forgot. This is kind of like a bonus hairstyle. This is not what I would wear running. But let's say you're just outside in the city and you want to tie your hair back. I have a hair claw. It's a jumbo hair claw because I have a lot of hair. And this is what I do. When I have a lot of hair, it's hard for me to even clip it because it just comes out. So I guess this is another hair hack. And it's called the beehive method, I think. I don't know. I kind of briefly saw it on YouTube shorts. So I hope this is how you do it. But basically, you take your hair, like you're about to clip it up as normal, but you take this and then twist it. And then you bring it, you make like, you don't make like a bun, but you kind of like do like a bring, basically just bring this end to this end. So now you have like, you know, you have like this flappy section here and then you have this section here. This section, the section that isn't flappy and feels a lot more bulkier and more secure, that is the place we're going to clip it. So we're just gonna clip it in between that bulk area and then this guy. And ta-da! Actually, no, that doesn't look good. Wait! Ta-da! Okay, I think this is better. I hope the back looks good. But yeah. All right, guys, that is all the hairstyles today. If you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, take care, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.